rookie.
I'm Larry Ridley.
But
welcome to the NFL.
I took him in like, I want to say the winding road to the
Super Bowl continues here in the divisional round.
We're two teams definitely exceeded expectations.
We welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. Straight ahead, we punch the second of two tickets to the AFC title game, and we've got a great one in store between the Miami Dolphins and the Tennessee Titans.
I don't know who. Oh, he's been playing Pittsburgh. Holy shit, they beat me.
So out comes this offense to take over for the first time.
They'll
be led out by their quarterback. Out of Oregon, it's Marcus Mariota.
Marcus Mariota's skill set can help continue to evolve the position of quarterback in the NFL. Because his ability to run with the football, you may not utilize it as little as other coaches have in the past. You may emphasize that part of the game a little bit more.
And he works his way forward for a couple up past the 30. Tackle made there by Kiko Alonso.
Seattle beat Philadelphia.
See if they stay on the ground for second
That's
down.
That's going to be a close game. Green Bay or Dallas. That'd be a good one.
One,
Oklahoma. Man, they dominated.
Again, it's Henry.
Need a block. Block.
There is. Open field here.
Nice.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Throw them off a little bit.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find.
Nice throw to Henry. Beautiful.
A whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily run very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with ability to block. And he ran the ball successfully behind that power set. So many times you hear today's
to
NFL described
right
as a space game.
You
get
the curve, there it is.
Into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner.
Get him out
in the flat and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleave. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they
you know
up a little bit in our meetings with the coaches.
I think I can go right here.
Drop it in. Guys
running yes. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. And the Titans take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. That's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted.
Shit,
was it an
audible? Completely, oh my God.
Was it just a play
I completely
call
forgot
that
it was on all pro.
No matter what, they had the
I
right call
so
on against
faster.
The right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
All right, well, that's okay. That's okay.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
There we go.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone.
Go defense. This is my rookie. He hasn't done that. He's not bad, but he's not doesn't have great either.
Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28. Avery Williamson there to make the stop.
Man,
decent
I'm
chunk
so
of yardage still left here,
play.
Second and seven.
Doesn't matter. I mean, I'm going anyway.
They run again with Ajayi. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
If they do, maybe you can get them, but they probably
they'll run it now. Out of the gun. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on forward. Here's Brad Wing now to punt it away on fourth down. Well, a well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. Very good return that time. 18 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
He's got time. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Great catch.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they drop it. Great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go through a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
A first down throw for Mariota. Flush to his right. And that's going to be incomplete. One of his main targets, Delanie Walker, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
On second down, here's Henry. And he is going to lose yardage here.
Okay.
We have played a quarter here in this AFC Divisional Playoff. And it's the Titans out in front early. We're back to Nashville. Right in. With the former Volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Titans with the football here to begin quarter number two. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Third and long here for Mariota. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion as we just saw there, that's winning football.
And Suckup will put this one right through, and that will make our score 9-0. So they were able to move the ball into the red zone, but they'll wind up coming away with just three.
Yeah, 32-yarder. That's equal to an extra point nowadays, and those are no problem for an NFL kicker.
Here's Jarvis Landry now on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. Three and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. And let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit better.
Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
Like that too.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more. So second down was a run play. Now let's see what they do on third.
They got a pass on this play, right?
They'll run it now out of the gun. And the broken tackle helps lead to a first down gain. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
Tannehill now to give to Ajayi. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Now, so nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
They'll try the air now with Tannehill. It's caught. Cameron, left side. The reception, good for seven. It's third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, Great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
A short game that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
He hasn't really done a whole lot. Not bad.
He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds. And they'll spot it right at the 20. And the Titans getting set to go. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But I also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
They'll run it again with Henry.
Get out of my way.
And
go.
Some space here.
Go.
Derrick Henry all alone. The 20.
Oh.
53 ticks left to go in this first half. Back with more AFC playoff action after this timeout.
Beautiful. Henry.
A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Larry Ridley at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. Trying to punch it in with Henry. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 7, and it'll set them back for second down.
Well, anytime it's a toss or a pitch play, it's a battle for the edges. Who's going to control the edge of the line of scrimmage? In other words, can the defensive guys hold their leverage? What we were always taught was keep your outside arm or outside shoulder free if you were playing on the play side, meaning the ball coming towards you. And anyone coming from the backside, they're pinching down and sliding down towards it to try and keep people kind of locked into one spot. And boy, what a great defensive play there. Worn out leverage, running to the football from the inside out, turned into a big loss of yardage.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Right.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win, and the name of the game for the defense.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense.
No, I'm not.
It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Can this defense hold them out?
I don't see why he can't.
Here we go now. Fourth and goal from the 2. They'll run for it with Henry. And he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. Derrick Henry taking it in from a yard out. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Out comes the Miami offensive unit. Now they get set to take over. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. On first down, it's Tannehill. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. On first down, Tannehill. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. No gain, and it's second down. Offense looking to avoid a 3rd and long. It's 2nd and 10.
Love the effort. Love the dramatics. Getting the feet down. How about a little step shuffle along the sideline there? Almost like a great ballet dancer or a tap dancer. All for no gain, though?
I was going to say, it's so pretty, and it gets you nothing. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And throw right side complete to Parker.
Are you
and
fucking kidding
way
me?
In for a Miami touchdown.
Oh, my God.
Devontae Parker, as the first half is winding down, and the Dolphins
seconds.
Are able to cut into this lead.
Yeah, you heard it, right?
Exhale.
You heard the exhale, and I'm taking that from their bench because finally, right before the half, they find a way to get the ball in the end zone and get some points on the board. Maybe they can use that
timeouts.
To kickstart them for the second half.
Yeah, just to get something before going into the lockers. And now in the second half.
Oh, my fucking God.
And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line.
God.
Let's just call that play exactly what it is.
Okay.
Needed.
Okay.
Because they wanted to get back in the game. And they knocked the ball free. And now they have a chance to do exactly that.
They got the chance. Now they have to take advantage. Now Tannehill. This is caught. The tight end, Cameron. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now hold everything here. Now another timeout here called by the Titans. So as they take it over, we step aside. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points.
And
Frank's kick is good. So it's on to halftime in this AFC Divisional Round matchup. As we'll send you down to... never mind, Larry. Forget your halftime report.
Yeah,
apparently, we are set for the third quarter of action already. This fielded at the 2. Oh, the spin. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take
Holy
it from there.
Shit,
see how that recipe works.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
From the gun on third down, Tannehill firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? What a really nice game right there. First down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
He didn't get it. He didn't get it.
About the 48-yard line. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. Here's Brad Wing now as he's on to punt for Miami. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline.
Okay.
Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Henry, the lone man in the backfield. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get happy if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened.
They got a guy in the outside.
They got in there, and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
Got a man, it's right.
There we go, baby.
And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
Big again.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times. Because he can trust you being in the right spot.
Yeah.
And they connected there and picked up the first down.
A good pickup there, 26 yards.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can right foot in there, and they were able to
get into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Kendall Wright, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors. But that's his second touchdown catch of this game.
Wow.
He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go.
Okay, so it's like two.
And they will line up now for the two-point try.
To make it a 14-point game. So,
Mariota will look to throw.
Nope.
And this one incomplete. So they went for the two. They don't get it. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut
him. Oh, my God.
Right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points.
Oh,
no way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Now it's a giant, and there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. Tackle made by Brian Arakpo.
While there was no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. I think we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster.
Back now in Nashville. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the 40.
A nickel set shown by the Titans on third down.
Thinking pass. Throwing on third down, Tannehill. He's got time in the pocket. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. Here's Brad Wing now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away.
Go. Oh, that guy got a first.
A terrific return there. 27 yards all told. And the Titans are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over first and 10. And a great spot to start this drive from here. And we spotlight Derrick Henry now. And we have seen a decline in the numbers. Where does the fall lie? Just him? Maybe the guys up front combination?
Well, you and I both know it's almost always a collective deal. But in this case, I think maybe the offensive line got a little overconfident. They had blocked so well in the first half, picked up on what the defense was doing. I think we've seen an adjustment now that they have not picked up on, and now they're being a little bit overwhelmed.
They keep it with Henry on first down. And Henry's hit. He lost the football.
Oh, my God. We got the football back. Oh, my God.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get him home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Oh. And a hit jarred loose. Right. It's incomplete.
A few yards.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. A play fake to Murray. Now Mario.
Oh, fuck.
Out to the flat. Man, that's complete that. To his running back. No gain at all on the play there. That brings up fourth. Right. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This from 54 yards away.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve. And that's what they did on that play. They went there. But the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
And out come the Dolphins now. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well.
Go to
something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like, you know, they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
Pick it.
Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
Now a first down throw, Tannehill. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. Give him eight on the play, and that'll make it second down.
Right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65.
Get him. Finally, somebody got him.
Escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Call it a loss of five, a big sack to bring up third down.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Look at the forward defensive back. You can hear all smiles up here.
I did not expect
that. I can hear my smile on that play.
Give him 7 yards on the play, and they do pick up the conversion on third down.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Here's Tannehill. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Landry. That he's brought down. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. Okay. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. On first down, it's Tannehill. And pass free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
On second and 10, Tannehill. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Here comes the eighth play of the drive. They need a full 10 yards on third down.
Touchdown at 2.3.
Tannehill throwing again. Finding time.
Just.
And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by Parrish Cox. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he's going to be taken. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They'll toss it to Henry. Fighting through.
There you go.
And they'll bring him down here. Now the Dolphins are going to take another timeout here. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
They're going to be greedy. No, not. They weren't playing tight. They were playing tight, I thought.
Henry will get it. He's been busy today.
Oh, fuck.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Now, hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. The pitch to Henry. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to make it third down and 10. And they're going to speed things up here.
Ball back, so.
On third down,
oh, fuck.
It comes.
Oh, my God.
The football. Mariota had it jarred loose.
Are you?
And this is picked up by the Dolphins.
Oh, my.
And they're set up in a golden position here right around the 10-yard line.
Well, that's one of those mistakes. That's a fumble that when they get to the sidelines, I know you're mad, coach, but look, we still got this locked down, but that's not necessarily true, is it?
Well, their hopes are slim, but you just hate to give them any hope. You could have sealed it right there.
Yeah, could have finished them off and taken away all hope, as we like to say.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
How many times when we see an incomplete pass, we just look at the receiver and say, should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put down the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially after starting in a tough spot defensively, but a good start there on first down.
That gave them a little extra confidence there. Starting, as you said, in a tough spot and being able to make a play on first down. So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing.
And this is caught down for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
And there's the touchdown that they needed. So they'll celebrate. But the guys on the sidelines, they've got to stay focused. The onside kick team, they need them to get the ball back.
Yeah, part one of the equation done. Now they need to convert and get that onside kick.
I think he's in there.
After reviewing the time, the ruling on the field stands.
It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. Time definitely of the essence now. Just under a minute to play, and here we go.
Let's fuck that up. 57 seconds. 57.
And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try. It was their only option.
I don't even think
this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a buck 50 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
They'll come out in the pistol. Now a play fake here on first down. He'll rifle this one deep.
Oh, my God!
And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Doyle Green Beckham, 31 yards. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead.
Holy shit.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
touch there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Suck up for the extra point. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go.
I mean, maybe not. I guess if they can return it and cover like an outside kick.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And the Dolphins offense now ready to go back out on the field. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence.
You got to give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and get some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
Now Tannehill. And
he got away.
Over. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle.
Man, I really don't think he's
holding defense.
Oh. Okay. Sure.
Well, they have the yards anyway, so they're going to decline the penalty. 23 yards on the play. On first and 10, Tannehill. He's going to let it fly. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down. And barring something unforeseen, this will be the last play of the game.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the flag.
And it's intercepted. And that should do it.
Beautiful.
Picked off by Jason McCourty. And that will write a finish to this ball game. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf.
Thanks,
they were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold.